Indian media is heavily funded and owned by anti-Hindu elements. Indian media is built and owned with only purpose of eliminating Hinduism from India. Once for all, finishing it off. Understand, Indian media does not spread news or facts of what happened. It spreads its narrative. Indian media has a clear narrative. Their narrative they spread using opinionated, distorted, black. See, not only opinionated, distorted facts, blatant lies. I wanted you guys to understand, I have some evidence to show. Many of the organizations, the international bodies, clearly prove Indian media is the worst corrupt media. Actually, Indian media, heavily funded and owned by anti-Hindu elements, literally you are out to destroy Hinduism. Please understand, Hindus all over the world need to understand this. And Hindus all over the world should stop trusting Indian media cult, Indian mass media cult. You should stop trusting Indian mass media cult as the source of information. That is all I am requesting. Please understand. I want to bring the truths to the world through this series of satsangs. Stop the Hindu Holocaust. Today, third day, I am going to speak for the 16 days and reveal all the truths to the whole world. Hindus all over the world, Hindu diaspora, should stop trusting Indian mass media cult. Indian mass media cult is most corrupt, heavily funded and owned by anti-Hindu elements with very clear narrative. See, their grand narrative is clear. They want to destroy everything related to Hinduism. They distort the facts, peddle blatant lies and rumors. The amount of hate speech they do on Hinduism, oh God. I want you to know, because I have experienced it firsthand. When they try to attack me, do the character assassination and do the hate speech, they spoke about all the major important Hindu principles and destroyed all the Hindu principles using my name. They started showing us I am an illegitimate, characterless person. Then the worship of Shivalinga comes. There is a huge article on palace symbol worship or palace worship on Shivalinga, and our Bhava Samadhi Darshan is called cross dressing. Not just one line, two line, full page articles, narratives, where our Vaidya Sarovar Anandalingam is described as palace symbol, palace worship and male organ worship, and Devi Bhava Samadhi Darshan. Understand, Bhava Samadhi Darshan is Hindu tradition. And unfortunately, even the neo-Hindus, this last two generation Hindus, forgot Bhava Samadhi Darshan is part of Hinduism. I can give you thousands of references, including Sri Ramakrishna wearing sari and living in the bhava. Tapovanam, near Tiruvannamalai, there is a place called Tapovanam. Jnanandagiri Swami, he used to wear sari and be in Devi Bhava during Navaratri. And till today, the Shivacharya who does, priest who does puja in Tiruvannikaval temple, the noon puja, he has to wear sari and dress up himself as Devi. In Devi Bhava Samadhi, he has to do puja to Paramashiva. The worst unfortunate thing, Hindus are made to forget about their roots, and Indian media, mass media cult. When I say mass media cult, I add cinema industry, entertainment industry. Indian mass media cult, cinema industry. I'll say almost 99%, only 1% exemption. They have a clear grand narrative agenda. They have a clear agenda to push their grand narrative. Eliminate everything Hinduism. Destroy everything related to Hinduism. To keep us cultural slaves, destroy our identity and backbone.